already. I am going to start 45 topics which are very important for NEET. So let me begin the first topic of those 45. The very first one is dimensional analysis. So first of all, let us understand what kind of questions are based on what questions may come. Those are three things. One is principle of homogeneity, deriving relations, conversion between system of units, different system of units. So these are the three types of questions most of the times they asked in the entrance point of view. To solve any such kind of question based on any of these topic, we need dimensional formula for few quantities. Dimensional formula of few quantities, and here I listed out those 9 different quantities. Like the very first one is distance, displacement, radius, perimeter, length, height, breadth, anything, thickness. For all those quantities, what we measure in terms of meter or centimeter, so that the dimension will become L power 1. Now the next one is velocity or speed, whose dimension is LT power minus 1. Same, and then charge and area, and finally volume. Please remember all these 9 quantities dimensional formula so that you can derive the dimension of any quantity which comes in physics syllabus, entire syllabus. You consider any quantity, but what you need to know is one formula which includes the quantity whose dimensions you want to find out. If you know the formula, then you can write the dimensions of that quantity using that relation. Just for example, I will tell you. For example, acceleration due to gravity relation is gm by r square. So from here you can find the dimensions of capital G, universal gravitational constant. Take the equation for the given quantity, capital G will become G R square by capital M. If there is any constant, dimensionless constant, ignore it, because we are talking about only dimensions. So these all three quantities have dimensions. Then dimension of universal gravitational constant will become gravitational acceleration. Acceleration means what? L t power minus 2. Here it is. Then r, radius. I told you meter or centimeter. So L power 1 whole square. So here mass. Mass means m. So that it will become, if it goes up, m power minus 1, L square, L power 3, T power minus 2. So this way you can derive dimension of any quantity. But only if you have the formula. So now similarly, you can solve the questions based on these three topics. So remember these all the 9 quantities dimensional formula, then you can solve any question. Let us try to understand how to solve those questions. The very first one, principle of homogeneity. So what is the meaning of principle of homogeneity? We can add or subtract similar dimensions only, nothing but. In every equation of physics, all the terms must have same dimensions. For example, you consider S equal to ut plus half at square. There is one term S, there is second term ut, there is third term half at square. What is the dimensions of displacement L? What is the dimensions of ut? U is speed, L t power minus 1, t is t. So that it will become t power minus 1 t 1 t 0, so L power 1. And what is the dimensions of half at square? Half is constant, so you ignore it. Acceleration, L t power minus 2, t square t power 2, so that it will become again L. So L. All the terms have same dimensions. If you take any one equation, the dimensions of LHS must be equal to dimensions of RHS. You can say in this way also. Here you are adding this with this. Suppose you are adding A with B, or you are subtracting A with B, then dimensions of A must be equal to dimensions of B. So based on this data, you can solve the questions related to principle of homogeneity. And also remember, if A by B is dimensionless, suppose there is no dimensions for a term which is ratio of two different quantities, then it represents dimensions of A must be equal to dimensions of B. And similarly, when you take product, if A and A dot B is dimensionless, product of A and B is dimensionless, then dimension of A is reciprocal of dimension of B. So remember these two things, so that it will help in solving the questions related to these three things. Now let me consider the second thing, that is deriving relations. So how the question will be asked based on this deriving relations? Either they may ask like one quantity, like suppose time period of a simple pendulum, depending upon length and acceleration due to gravity, then derive the relation between them. We knew that T is 2 pi root L by G, time period of a simple pendulum. But in the question, in dimensional analysis, how they will give is, the time period of a simple pendulum is depending on length of the pendulum and acceleration due to gravity. Then how to get this relation using dimensional analysis is, you have to take 1 power as x, dimensional, and other one like y. If 3 quantities are there, then take the third one, power like z. Then take the dimensions LHS, take the dimensions of RHS, and compare both sides, the power, dimension of M, dimension of L, dimension of T, so that you will get the equations in terms of this unknown quantities X, Y, if it exists, Z also. If X, Y are there, then two equations you require. If X, Y, Z are there, then you require three equations. So this way you can solve the questions. Sometimes they'll ask you the question in different manner. Method is same, but they'll ask you the question in different manner. So what is that kind of question is? They'll ask you, derive the units of one quantity, suppose like force, by considering any three they will mention as fundamental quantities. So any three derived quantities only they will ask you to consider as their fundamental quantities, like suppose velocity, linear momentum, and acceleration. Consider them as fundamental quantities and derive the relation for force. Like now force is a derived quantity which is depending upon the fundamental quantities like velocity, acceleration, and linear momentum, suppose. Then this you will take it as x, y, z, and you will write the dimension of force LHS dimension of velocity, acceleration, linear momentum as RHS, then you will compare the dimension both sides, m dimension, l dimension, t dimension, then you will solve the equations. So that kind of question also they'll ask you in the entrance point of view. Then last one, conversion between system of units, different system of units. So what is this conversion means? Suppose in one system, let's take 1 meter. So length of one object or something is 1 meter. This is meter. Which system? SI system. Now, if you write the same quantity in CGS system, it will become 100 centimeter. So 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. So here 1 is numerical value in SI system. Let's take N1. Meter is unit. Let's take U1. Here 100 is numerical value in another system, CGS system. Let's take it as N2. And centimeter is the unit. Let's take it as U2. So N1 U1 equal to N2 U2. So using this formula, you can solve the questions related to conversion between system of units. Sometimes they will ask you the question in this manner, like convert joules into earth. I mean, 1 joule equal to how many earths or any other unit. They will ask you to convert the unit from SI to CGS or CGS to SI or from SI to some new system. Then what is the method is, you have to take like N1 and here you have to take one set of M1, L1, T1. Then it is equal to N2, another set of M2, L2, T2. They have given joule, suppose. That is the known system that you take here. They are asking you to convert into CGS, that is this one, another one. 1 joule, suppose. So N1 is 1. Joule means, what is the dimension? Energy dimension means m l square t power minus 2. M1 L1 T1. Similarly, now N2, M2 L2 T2. But whatever may be the system, this is SI, this is CGS, but the dimension remains same. So here also 2 minus 2 will come. But this first set M1, L1, T1 is in SI system and this M2, L2, T2 is in CGS system. So there are two systems. So what are the values of this M1, L1, T1 and M2, L2, T2? Fundamental or base values. Like if you consider SI, what are the values? Mass means 1 kg, length means 1 meter, time is 1 second. Similarly, CGS system if you consider, mass is 1 gram, length is 1 centimeter, time is 1 second. You have to substitute this. And one unit numerical value they will give you and they will ask you the another system numerical value. Then you can find it. But sometimes also they will give unknown system. They will mention you like convert the unit from SI system to another unknown system, where base values they will mention, like suppose for mass base value is 10 kg and for length base value is 2 meter and 1 minute is the base value for time. Then you have to take that MLT values as 10 kg, 2 meter and 1 minute. When they said you to take one unknown system. So first you have to take care whether they are asking the question between SI to CGS or CGS to SI or either from SI or CGS to some unknown system. Then only you can proceed to solve the question. Then it will be good. So this is what the type of questions what we can expect based on the very first topic. What is that? Dimensional analysis. Let us try to solve 2-3 questions based on this so that you will understand how to solve the questions also. As I told you, the very first topic is dimensional analysis. Let us discuss few questions based on whatever we discussed. Consider the first question. given as F is force given in terms of alpha beta times exponential of minus x square by alpha kt, where alpha beta are constants, dimensional constants, and x is distance, k is Boltzmann constant, t is temperature. Then we need to find the dimensions of beta. First, remember all exponential, logarithmic, all trigonometric functions like sine theta, cos theta, anything you consider, all are dimensionless. So here this is also dimensionless. So very first thing what you can conclude is the dimension of force must be equal to dimension of alpha beta, because LHS dimension should be equal to RHS, and here this quantity is dimensionless. So F should be equal to what? Alpha beta. Now you know the force dimensions. I told you to remember those 9 quantities, and force is one of them. Now alpha beta, if you know alpha dimension, then beta dimension will become dimension of force by dimension of alpha. But how to find the dimension of alpha? Here this is dimensionless quantity. What is that? X square by alpha kt is dimensionless. And I told you one more thing, if a by b is dimensionless, then a dimension must be equal to b dimension. Now this is like a, this is like b, then dimension of alpha kt should be equal to dimension of x square. Then dimension of alpha will become dimension of x square divided by dimension of kt. But in kinetic theory you will get one relation where kinetic energy for one molecule, gas molecule, per degree of freedom is 1/2 kt. So that dimensions of kt equal to what? Energy. But if you know this relation, then only you can understand this one. That's why I told you it is very important to know all the relations, whatever is there in the physics, then only you can solve the questions related to dimensional analysis. So that the kt dimension is equivalent to energy dimension, so that you can replace, you can substitute here, dimension of x square means l square, distance, dimension of kt means energy, m l square t power minus 2. Now here l square get cancelled, so m power minus 1 and t power 2, this is the dimension of alpha. But we want dimension of beta. So if you take dimension of beta, then dimension of force by dimension of alpha, dimension of force is m l t power minus 2, by dimension of alpha is m minus 1 t power 2, and if this goes up, then m power plus 1, 1 1 2, m power 2, and l power 1 t power 2, if it goes to numerator, t power minus 2, minus 2 minus 2, t power minus 4. This is the dimension of what? Beta. So this way you can solve the questions using what? Principle of homogeneity. This is the one question. Similarly, let us take the second question. As I discussed, the second thing is deriving relations. So here they are asking you, consider speed, acceleration and force as fundamental quantities and derive the dimension for pressure. So pressure is depending upon speed, acceleration and force, and I told you to take power x, y and z. Then what is the next step I told you to do? Take the dimensions both sides, LHS and RHS, pressure, force by area, so that force is mLT power minus 2 by area is L square. Both are there in the list, but you should know the relation. Then speed, it is also there in the list. LT power minus 1 power x. Acceleration, LT power minus 2 power y. And force, mLT power minus 2 power z. So here m L minus 1 t power minus 2 equal to, there is no m, there is no m here, m power what? Z. Then L power x, L power y, L power z. So what it will become? X plus y plus z. T power minus x, t power minus 2y, t power minus 2z. So t power minus x minus 2y minus 2z. Compare both sides, what is the power of m, l and t. So if you compare m power, z is 1. Similarly, if you compare l power, then minus 1 equal to x plus y plus z. But here z is 1, so minus 1 equal to x plus y plus 1. Bring this 1 this side, minus 2, x plus y, another equation. Then here t power, if you compare, then here minus 2. Minus 2 equal to minus x minus 2y minus 2z. And z is how much? 1. So minus 2 equal to minus x minus 2y minus 2. If you bring this minus 2 this side, minus 2 will become plus 2. 2 minus 2, 0. 0 equal to minus x minus 2y. So bring this x this side. Then x equal to how much? Minus 2y. X is minus 2y. Substitute here. So minus 2 equal to x is minus 2y plus y. So minus 2y plus y how much? Minus y. So equal to minus y implies y equal to what? 2. So this is the y value. Then you can find x value either by substituting here or here. So x is how much? Minus 2y. So minus 2 into 2 how much? Minus 4. So what is x? Minus 4. What is y? 2. What is z? 1. So what is the relation will become then? P is proportional to v power x minus 4, a power y 2 and f power 1. So this is what the relation between pressure and the given fundamental quantities. So this is the second type of question. Similarly, let us consider the third one. What is the third question if you see? There they have given the linear mass density in SI system. So mass per, sorry, not linear mass density, surface mass density. Density is three types. Per unit length, per unit area, per unit volume. Generally density means per unit volume we consider. But here they are mentioning mass per unit area. So surface density. How much is the value? 64 kg per meter square. And find the numerical value in other system in which unit of length and mass is 25 cm and 50 gram. I told you to solve this kind of questions is the formula N1 U1 equal to N2 U2. This is, you consider SI system, this is new unit, new system. Now here in the SI system, what is the numerical value? 64. And what is the unit? Kg per meter square. That means the dimension is ml t power minus 2 t power 0. L power minus 2 t power 0. And here N2 is the numerical value in new system. We don't know what is that. That is what exactly you have to find. But the dimension remains same. M L power minus 2 t power 0. You take this as one set. This as another set. And this is in SI system. So what is the base value for mass? 1 kg. What is the base value for length? 1 meter. What is the base value for time? 1 second. But in the new system, they have given the base values M2. What is it? Mass. How much? 50 gram. And L2. How much? 25 centimeter. Of course, T2. They have not given and we don't require, because here t power is how much? 0. That's why they did not mention it. If it is required, they will give you the value, then you can substitute that also. Now N2, bring this side. 64 times m1 by m2, l1 by l2. What is the power? Minus 2. Then t is not there. Then substitute the values. m1, 1 kg. 1 kg is how much? 1000 grams. Because I am taking, it is also in grams. And what is m2? 50 grams. l1, 1 meter. But here centimeter. So what is 1 meter? 100 centimeter. Divided by l2, 25 centimeter. Whole power how much? Minus 2. Here gram, gram, centimeter, centimeter cancel. If you calculate the value, 64 times 1000 by 50, that is 20. 100, 25, 4s are. But 4 power minus 2, that will come to denominator. So 1 by 4 square, how much? 16. 16, 4s are 64. 4, 20, 80. So what is the numerical value in new system? 80. So the numerical value in SI system is 64, which is equal to numerical value 80 in another new system. So please understand the each and every question step by step and try to solve similar kind of questions so that you will get definitely 4 marks, right? So thank you so much. So let us continue with our second topic.